Hallelujah, hallelujah. This morning, as I continue to meditate over the things that are taking place in this nation, around us, and across the nations of the world, in the light of the prophecies, ancient prophecies that are already taking place in our days, as I begin to meditate, I was reading Daniel chapter 9 and verses 20 to 23. Daniel was a beloved of the Father. When Daniel began to pray, Gabriel was dispatched from the throne of God to come and bring him the answer. Gabriel said to Daniel, from the moment you began to pray, your prayer was heard in the throne. And I have come quickly to give you wisdom and to give you understanding of the things that you're praying about. From the moment Daniel began to apply his heart to understand what was taking place in his time, it was a time of crisis. His people were in exile. Gabriel is one of those who do not leave the presence of God easily. But he was sent. He's a high-ranking angel. He was dispatched. Why? Because Daniel was a beloved. God the Father loved Daniel very much. Daniel was a prophet who developed intimacy with the Father, with the throne. He was connected with the throne, and because of his intimacy, when he applied his heart to understand what was happening in his days, to discern the times in which he lived, to understand and properly interpret prophetically what was happening, so that he would pray again effectively, and his prayers would result in a remnant of his people to begin to return to their homes of origin. Intimacy. I've been talking about intimacy. This morning, I would like to encourage you, just like Daniel, to seek intimacy with God. Daniel did not become the beloved of the Father by accident. The scriptures tell us in the beginning of the book of Daniel that Daniel refused to partake of the table of the king of Babylon. Today, our culture is a table. And it grieves me so much to see the people of the church partaking at the table of the culture. I have spoken and dealt with many men and women of God, apostles, prophets, people speaking in tongues, baptized in the Holy Spirit, as they say, but they are completely partaking everything that is happening in the culture. There is no distinction between the people of the world and these people, even though they are the people in the church. But they are partaking. They are under the control. They have to consume everything that the culture serves. They take it. But Daniel refused. And because of that, because he rejected the world, because he would not allow his mind to be conformed to the mind of the times in which he lived, because Daniel became an ally to the throne, and he aligned his heart with the heart of the Father, to know the thought of the Father, to know the purposes of the Father, to know the original eternal intentions of the Father and his plans. Daniel applied his heart to understand those things. Those things had great value to Daniel. He rejected what the world offered, and he embraced what God offered. He had the mind of the Father, the mind of the Lord, concerning the circumstances of his times. Today, we need such people. I encourage you to become such people. A people of the mind of Christ, the people of the intentions, understanding the times in which we live, discerning properly the situation, the circumstances, the events that are taking place, interpreting them properly in the light of the ancient prophecies that are already coming to pass. I encourage you to begin to pursue that kind of intimacy. Reject this world. Do not be conformed to the patterns of this world. Do not be conformed. Do not conform yourself, which means that do not be defined. Do not let the pattern of this world, what this world has defined as a success in ministry, what this world has defined as a success in life, the concept of beauty for a woman, the concept of good looking, everything that the world has defined to determine what is acceptable and what is not acceptable, what will be admired and what is not admired, all the fashions, the way you dress, the choice of clothes, the choice of shoes, how you dress even in the church, and even at home, on the street. The mindset of this world. We must renounce these things. We renounce the mindset of this world, O God. We renounce the patterns of this world. We refuse to be conformed, to conform ourselves to the mindset of this world, to the mindset of this generation. We refuse to be conformed and to conform ourselves to its patterns, to the way its concept about success, to its idea about success in ministry, about what a church looks like, what a man of God should look like, what a woman of God should look like. We refuse to be patterned by those things. We refuse, hallelujah, to the definition of a successful church, what it looks like. It has to look like, where it has to gather, what style of music it has to play. You know, today entertainment is what is taking place in the church. Why? Because the leaders are desperate to attract and draw and keep crowds in the church. This is not the way God is calling us to function. Our families, our marriage relationships, we refuse to pattern ourselves to follow the model, to conform to the model of what a husband should do, a wife should do, or be, or treat each other like children towards their parents, parents towards their children. The relationship between a pastor and the member, how you treat your pastor, how you honor your pastor, your leaders. Isn't it amazing that in the United States, the things that people say about the president, there is no honor, no respect at all. Do not conform yourself. Daniel did not. and he became the darling of the throne. And when he prayed heavenly prayers. His prayers were in line with the thoughts of God. His prayers were based on what the intentions of God were. He did not pray according to the way he thought. He did not pray according to the desires of the world or the needs of the world. He prayed based on God's eternal plan, God's eternal intention, God's purposes for his people, for the kingdom of God. That is the way Daniel prayed. And such prayers moved the throne of God. As we continue to talk about building the altar, the golden altar of prayer in your home, the golden altar of prayer in your life, the golden altar of prayer in your business, in your place of work, in the church, in the neighborhood, in the cities, in the nation. We need to rebuild the golden altar. And the golden altar is positioned before the throne of God. You can read that in the book of Revelation. You can see chapter 8 throughout the book of Revelation. If you read throughout the book of Exodus, the instructions that were given to Moses, the golden altar of incense was positioned in the center, in the middle of the holy place, right at the entrance. It was the last step, the last item before you went through the curtain that led into the Holy of Holies. But before you came to the golden altar of incense, the first place that you stop is the brazen altar of sacrifice, where you give yourself as a living sacrifice daily, like Daniel, forsaking that which is of the world. In Psalm chapter 24, as we studied, who shall ascend the mountain of the Lord? He who has a pure heart. That requires for you to lay yourself on the altar voluntarily. I will not come down, O God. Bring your sword and bring your fire. Open and search and investigate me. According to Psalm 139 and verses 22 to 24, investigate me, O God. Search me. You know my anxious thoughts, Lord. See if there is any offensive ways in me and remove it. Cut it off. Take it out. I give you permission, O God. Take it out. Anything that's offensive to you, God, to your thoughts, to your purpose, to your plans, anything that is incompatible with your eternal plans and thoughts and purposes, oh God, with my destiny and the destiny of this city, the destiny of this generation, oh God, I give you permission with your sword, cut it off, and with your fire, purify me. Purge me, O God. Remove everything that is not of you. Purify me, O God, of everything that defiles me. Take it all. Daniel refused to partake, to eat from the table of the king. He refused to be conformed to the pattern of his times. But in the contrary, he applied his heart to understand the throne, the thought from the throne, the desire from the throne, the golden altar being positioned before the throne of God. Incense, worship, and intercession rising up night and day, night and day. We're talking about building a house of prayer 24/7, worship 365, prayer room. This, you must become the altar, the golden altar. I must become the golden altar. Now begin to ask the Lord to give you understanding, just like Daniel. Understanding of the times in which we live. Understanding of the situation, of what the thoughts of God are, what his intention and purpose is for these times, for times such as these. Esther, understood her times. She decreed fasting, that is the altar of sacrifice, the brazen altar. She decreed fasting, and then she went in to the throne to see the king. And the king empowered her. Say, go and fight for your people. Go and fight for your children. Go and fight for your nation. Go and fight for your kingdom. Go and fight for your God. Let Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, we fight for your interest, for your inheritance in the saints. We fight for that which you paid such a heavy price for. You must receive your reward in my life. You must receive your reward in the form of a life transformed, a life of a self of crucified self, a life of self-denial, a life that honors you, a life that exalts you and blesses you night and day. This is your reward in my life. I will fight for my children are worth fighting for. My grandchildren are worth fighting for. This generation is worth fighting for. This city is worth fighting for. And this morning, I encourage you to study the life of Daniel, the beloved of the Lord. Lord, reveal to me the secret of the heart of Daniel, who became your beloved, so much that you would send Gabriel to bring him understanding and wisdom and knowledge into the things he applied his heart to know your will. Your eternal will, your eternal purpose, your eternal intent. Lord, I need to know what is your purpose for my life, for my children, for my grandchildren, for my family, for this ministry, for the people you have sent into this ministry, for the city I live in, for the neighborhood I live in, for this nation, for such a times as this. Like Esther, I come to the throne. Hallelujah. You shall stretch your scepter unto me and empower me to go out and fight, engage in spiritual warfare, fight in prayer, fast with fasting, fight making declarations, kingly declarations, royal declarations. We renounce, we reject, we refuse to be engaged in earthly prayers, prayers that are focused on the earthly. We want prayers that are focused on the heavenly, the will of the Father, the purposes of the Father. Give us the mind of Christ, wisdom and understanding into these things in the name of Yeshua. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. We bless you, Lord, this morning. I bless you.